Hi guys, I'm Lena. Welcome to my channel where we explore the world of analog photography and darkroom printing. I wish I could say this video was motivated by my concern about the ecological issues, but it was in fact my water bill that made me think of optimizing the waste of resources. I've always done 1 hour of washing in an archival washer in running water, but after realizing just how much goes to waste, I embarked on a long journey to figuring out the best method possible. So in this video, I want to share with you the results of my quite surprising findings, along with an experiment that will show you the various washing methods and their results. To understand how to wash better, we need to address fixing first. Fixer removes unexposed residue silver. So if an image is underfixed, guess what? It will develop stains over time. So fixing properly is extremely important. And you might think that fixing a little bit longer is a good idea. However, the fixer penetrates the emulsion layer and the barilla layer and gets stuck in the base. And that's where the long washing times for fiber-based paper come from. Here goes a little footnote. Resin-coated paper has a different base, so 15 minutes washing under running water is sufficient, and this video applies to fiber-based papers only. One solution came in form of rapid fixers. The idea is that in 1 or 2 minutes, a very strong fixer has enough time to eliminate all the residue and exposed silver from the emulsion layer, however, doesn't have time to penetrate the fibers, which sounds good in theory, however, there are a couple of issues. First of all, you have to have your chemistry really fresh, because 1 or 2 minutes is a very short time for it to spread and work evenly. And if it's a tiny bit exhausted with such short and precise times, your margin of error is really tiny. Second issue, imagine accidentally leaving your print in the super strong fixer for a little longer. And imagine all that strong fixer going into the fiber layer. Does not sound good. That being said, I personally do use rapid fixers while obsessively checking for freshness and always overfixing a little bit to be on the safe side, but that's a long interesting discussion for a completely different video, so let's stick with washing for now. We will now be conducting an experiment. 4 sheets of effluent fiber-based matte paper have been developed, went through a stop bath, and 2 minutes of 1+9 Ilford rapid fixer. They have been rinsed for 20 seconds and underwent a residue hypotest. You can clearly tell the paper isn't washed at all, and all the sheets had an equal start, but ended up in 4 different settings. First one went to a regular archival washer with running water. Second one was put in a tray without any water changes or movements. Third one went into a big tray with a pump that makes water circulate without being renewed. And fourth might seem a little weird, but my friend sent me this thread on a Russian analog photo discussion board about using ultrasound for speeding up the washing process. So I just had to give it a try, because why not? And here goes another footnote, now addressing the water volume variable. In fact, it's not that important, as I've encountered calculations that you can entirely dissolve all the residue fixer in a 30 by 40 sheet with just 0.5 liter of water. That is theory. You do need more. But after about 2 liters, all the additional water volume does not increase efficiency. Thank you. You can clearly see that all methods, maybe except for the ultrasound washer, gave absolutely identical results in 1.5 hours with really dramatic difference in water waste. So let's see why those methods worked the way they did. Initially, the washing process goes faster where circulation is involved, as this is how fixer gets removed from the upper layers most efficiently. However, the lower layers do not benefit from circulation. I don't think they even require it at all, as at this point, it's the dissolving process that comes into play. As long as the paper is in clean water, the thiosulfate will go into the water until the concentration of thiosulfate in the water and then the paper becomes equal, which will probably never happen, as a 30 by 40 print holds like at most 50 milliliters of chemistry. And you can imagine you do not need gallons of water to dissolve this amount. Another factor, and that is where I think the ultrasound washer failed, is that thiosulfate is heavier than water, and constant vibrations were simply not letting it go to the bottom of the tray and remain there. But that is just my theory. However, it explains why the simple tray washing method worked so surprisingly well, even without changing water. This method is used even by professional printers, it's very widespread, and there is an option of changing water every 5 minutes, which is complete waste, to just moving prints from one tray to another, getting it to increasingly cleaner water. Be aware that thiosulfate remains on the back of the print, so you might want to add an extra half hour face up in fresh water if you want to go for that method. If you have an archival washer and want to stick with it, don't turn the water on too strongly, as the current and bubbles will likely create patterns and not wash the print surface evenly. I will leave the formula for the residue hypotest if you wish to prepare it yourself under this video, along with a link to the ready-made product. Mind that removing all thiosulfate from the paper is not only kind of impossible, but also undesirable. Ironically, a little bit of residue fixer ensures the long-term stability of your image, especially if it is to be exhibited. You can figure all that out comparing the stain color to the Kodak chart. I will also leave a link below this video to an article that explores the subject of washing really in detail if you wish to investigate more. It has some differences with what I was saying here, so it's an interesting read. For instance, it stresses agitation as an extremely important factor, while I tested a lot in completely still water and still got great results with the same washing times. Another thing, it says that thiosulfate is not that much heavier than water to make a difference. However, I talked to experienced printers and industry professionals who said that the difference is still substantial. So point is, never fully rely on a book, article, discussion thread. Don't even fully trust me. You have to figure it all out for yourself, because no one in this world has a setting identical to yours. No one has your darkroom, your room temperature, your humidity levels, or your tap water. So by now we covered a lot of fundamental factors about washing fiber-based paper, and I hope that this video will help you have smaller water bills, make your art process more eco-friendly, and possibly save you from investing into a super expensive archival washer, because same results can be achieved with just letting your prints float in a sink or bathtub. Thank you so much for watching. Have fun in the darkroom. See you in the next video. Bye!